I've been fortunate enough to be able to test out a lot of different tablets from Huion, from their lowest end to their highest end, and here's actually more of a mid-range solution, I would say, but one that had me genuinely surprised for a lot of reasons. As somebody that graduated from art school with a bachelor's on animation, I will mostly be talking about my experiences with 2D work in general. Introducing the Huion Canvas 22 Plus, if you're starting to get serious with your work, this is probably the way to go. Let's go ahead and dive right in. Before we continue, I just wanted to remind you that we have a Twitch channel where we stream every Friday and Saturday from 8 p.m. and to 10 p.m. Eastern Time, so why not go ahead and drop a follow? And also, don't forget to follow us on Twitter and Instagram, and also make sure to check out the merch store. There's plenty of black and white sweetness to choose from up there, so go ahead and check that out. And then make sure to take a look at the podcast as well, as the podcast always goes live every Wednesday and Sunday. And with that said, enough rambling, let us get straight into the video. I would just like to quickly point out that Huion did indeed send this over to me for review. However, I will be testing this display and giving you my honest thoughts on it nonetheless. With disclaimers out of the way, let's go ahead and talk about the actual unboxing. It comes in a pretty big box, and inside, there is a little box that holds all of your accessories, things like cables and adapters, and the stylus, the pedestal for it, power cables, and more. But going even further through the box, you will find the display tablet itself and the stand, which you do have to screw in, but luckily, it does come with screws already, so that is pretty easy to do. And once that's done, you're pretty much ready to go. And the exterior design is going to consist of both plastic and glass. For the most part, it is going to be a large display tablet with thick bezels and plastic surrounding the corners. You will find a power button, an OK slash adjustment button, and directional buttons for controls, and a back button, essentially. You will also find two USB-C ports and one USB 3.1 port. This display is very slick and look a lot like the newer Cintiq tablets. Good stuff for sure. And I'm sure that because of that, this tablet may also appeal to a lot of different people. However, let's go ahead and talk about that display. This monitor features a 22-inch 1920x1080 IPS resolution display that in short looks much better than I was expecting. It gets very bright and the colors on it are very flattering. I want to say that by default this display is accurate, but it looks off from the rest of my displays. However, it is still a very enjoyable experience, and you can still tune it to your liking if you really want to. It does have a 140% sRGB color gamut after all. For doing animation and drawings in general, I've had a wonderful time working with this nicely sized display, for sure, and I really like it. This monitor does come with your typical Huion stylus, the same one you get with the most budget models and even the higher end ones, unless you get the models that do feature the PW517 stylus. The stylus that it includes in the box has more issues with scratching once it starts to wear out, so I recommend getting the PW517 instead. And with that said, this pretty much just means that you will be replacing your tips more often than not to avoid damage to your display. And now with that out of the way, we can actually start talking about performance. Because in terms of performance, it has been pretty smooth. One thing I didn't mention is that this display is matte textured, but it still feels very smooth to use when drawing, and I would consider this to be the perfect combination of anti-glare and smoothness, even if it doesn't show that way on camera. With that said, drawing on this display with the stock stylus has been a great experience, but I will get into that pretty soon. So firstly, let's go ahead and talk about performance in Photoshop, since I actually like using a stylus when editing photos, but it does depend on what I'm working on. When it comes to retouching faces and things like that, the precision of a stylus is a godsend compared to a mouse. However, I get a lot of fine-tuning that works very well, and I can really get detailed with a lot less stress using a stylus. Not to mention that this display, being as beautiful as it is, definitely makes working on projects much easier. I typically don't draw on Photoshop, so I can't really comment too much on the experience of drawing there, since I actually really don't like using Photoshop for drawing, if I'm completely honest. But we are going to test out a different drawing software, and that is going to be Sketchbook Pro. And yes, I do love drawing in Sketchbook Pro, and you will judge me for this one for sure. But I love animating here too, using the flipbook feature. Drawing feels as precise as ever, with colors looking incredibly vibrant. I feel very comfortable comfortable drawing on this display with the stylus using Sketchbook Pro, and that involves things like shading and so much more. Tilting and pressure sensitivity also work pretty great here too. If you wanted to do any kind of sales work, or if you really needed to get detailed, this is a great software and used in tandem with this drawing display. And when it comes to animations here with the flipbook feature, while you're much more limited in the amount of layers and tools that you can use, you do get a very simple yet effective animating experience, at the very least if you learn to cope with the options that you're given. I prepared this very quick and easy short just to show what an animation drawn on this tablet could look like, though this is obviously lacking in detail. However, the animating experience here is still pretty great, and if I had weeks and months to dedicate on a fully shaded, well animated short, then I would definitely go ahead and show that to you. And I did actually animate an entire thesis project using one of these tablets. I actually did it in part with a Canvas 13 from Huion and with the Canvas Pro 24. If you're interested in seeing what an animation would look like from that I created using both of those tablets, then I'll be making sure to leave a link to that animation down in the description so that you don't miss that. And now let's go ahead and talk about an even more popular animation software. In fact, one of the best ones out there too. This is going to be Clip Studio Pro. While I'm comfortable drawing on this software so far and working on still projects, on here is still honestly pretty great thanks to its array of tools and smoothness overall. I still haven't gotten the hang of animating so well on this software though, I'm going to be honest. There's certainly a lot more of a learning curve here for me, and I have a lot of practicing to do. However, until I end up mastering this, I can say that pressure sensitivity is great here and that the toolset is pretty fantastic as well. So if you're used to using this program or want to learn it, this is a great tablet or drawing display to use overall. However, this display will falter for some people in some aspects, as it did for me. For instance, I'm sure that you've noticed the lack of any customizable keys on this display. That was a miss, as you're stuck relying on the two remappable buttons on your stylus, and I don't love only having that as an option. It's rather limiting, to be frank, and the stand is not very smooth to use, from my experience at least. Maybe I just suck at adjusting this display with it, but it always feels like a jump every time I try to make an adjustment. It has gotten a little bit scary at times, but that's really a lot more minor of a complaint since it probably is more so my fault. Though my next complaint would have to be the inclusion of the older model of the stylus that when it starts to wear out, and the tip I mean, it can actually start scratching your screen, which is something that I really do not like. I did not receive the PW517 stylus that fixes this issue with this display, but I did have one already from using a Canvas Pro 24 in the past. And that's really all I've got to say. I'm very happy with this display, for sure, and I feel very comfortable working with it, in spite of whatever project ends up piquing my interest. In spite of its shortcomings, I still think that it is a pretty great value at around $550, since it does come with pretty much everything that you need. You don't need this as a starting tool at all though, but I would recommend getting this when you're ready to step up your animation or stills work. That said, this is a very strong recommendation under those circumstances, but if you're looking for something cheaper, Huion does have a vast selection of tablets like the Canvas 13 or even the HS611 that you can definitely go ahead and take a look at. I've reviewed both and I'll be leaving links to those videos down in the description in case you're interested in looking at other options. And speaking of other options, if you're interested in purchasing any of the tablets that I mentioned in this video, then I'll be making sure to leave affiliate links down to Amazon in the description. If you end up using any of my links, I do get a small commission that does help the channel out quite a bit, so I would really appreciate it if you use those. And also, do not forget that Luster is an option in case you're looking for sales or other kinds of alternatives regarding drawing monitors and things like that. Then Luster is a tool that is going to help you find other kinds of alternatives, and it's going to list them for you while also simultaneously letting you know if there are any sales out there right now so that you can get the best price possible. So links to that are going to be below, and also something that may come in handy for you as well is going to be an Abunda link, because if you end up going with Abunda, then it gives you the option to finance any given tablet, which is something that could really come in handy. It's not really like using a credit card or anything like that, just through fewer payments along the way. I think think that it is a pretty cool service, and I can strongly recommend it. So do make sure to use that link below if you would rather finance your monitor display instead. And also do make sure to stop by the Tech Summit podcast, where we like to talk about all things tech and news and things like that. Links to that are going to be, of course, down below, and it does go live every Wednesday and Sunday, so do keep an eye out for that. Or you can also subscribe so that you don't have to remember any times. Also, make sure to follow me on Twitch, where I like to stream every Friday and Saturday from 8 p.m. to 10 p.m. Eastern Time. I like to play some games, talk to you guys, answer any questions. So yeah, do catch me over there. Follow me on Instagram and Twitter. But with all of that social media stuff out of the way, this has been Francisco from Tech Summit. Thank you so much for watching, and I will be seeing you all later. Enjoy.